organizers, I want to welcome us once again. It's my pleasure to be talking to us this evening for a few minutes. I know the time has been fast spent because I've been here since about 2 o'clock. Hopefully, it's at 3 o'clock. I don't believe in African time, so I try to get to my event. And in any case, I think one of the things we need to deal with as employers, as entrepreneurs, as Nigerians, we really need to know how to deal with time. That's one of the major things I think we have to ensure we get out of our way. I'll be speaking to us briefly on the theme of this event, which is back to celebrating innovation and creativity. It gives me a lot of joy each time I'm invited to talk to employers, entrepreneurs, or business owners. It's one area that I'm personally, thinking as a ministry. When I say ministry, I mean something I'd love to do for the rest of my life to support startup business, the going one. And that's what I do, majorly for living. But at the multinationals and the startup ones. So when I saw the invite, I felt so glad about it. And it's also amazing to, publish the magazine that I call Business Quotient Magazine, trying to deal with small businesses especially. Because from research and from my years of, working along this path, and by sheer grace, I'm also a business of few countries. Part of the country is Togo, Cotonou, Ghana, I traveled abroad that time. Come on, is Ghana not abroad?
It is.
Is Togo not abroad? Even Cotonou is not abroad. Yeah, now, I spent quite a lot of money there. I wonder why you mean like that. Even I'm planning now to travel to Nigeria. I want to visit another country abroad today. So, that actually has given me the confidence on the fact that the developed economy, the great economy of the world, that we cherish so much, are built on small businesses. And what they do is by making or doing it right, doing something different, something that is created to solve problems. So when we talk about innovation and creativity, we're talking about the fact having to do what sometimes we call unusual and solving problems in an unusual way. And for a part of the world, again, because we depend more on importation, we believe more in the product that still is not from US or from other countries, we believe so much in those products. And that has made us to be lacking behind so many things. Most of the products or most of the things that they bring there are sometimes what we call lab tests or lab exams. Some of those products are actually cherished. Sometimes students are just working on practical, and somebody just bought something, and before you know it, because the economy or the country, the system is programmed to support ideas, support innovation, and then they develop it. And before you know it, we get crazy about it. And if you had a story about Facebook, you realize that Facebook was just like somebody was just playing with some idea. And before you know it, became the internet. And you know what that was today. And so for us as entrepreneurs, we need to go beyond our limitation, challenge ourselves. And for all one of the things I always encourage entrepreneurs is that don't just involve idea. Because you want to compete, or you want to make money, or because also you want to solve your partner problem. It won't last. And if you agree with me, Nigeria is over 100 years. It is whatever. By independence, they are over 50 years. Now tell me which organization, or how many organizations that are over 100 years, or if are 100 in Nigeria. Okay, let's pick that one. Nigeria independence, how many businesses are over 50 or above 50 in Nigeria? Now, because most times we start businesses because we want to solve our own problem. I just want to feed myself and my partner. And when we go beyond that level, we want to do it because we want to show somebody who I also can do it. We want to do it because we want to make money. I think the best thing and the best solution is to or establish a business or a product because you want to solve problems. If your product is not for a problem or a solution to a problem, it will go for a while. And after a while, the product vanishes. The idea goes down the drain. Very few companies that when you are growing up, some of us are still growing, but some of you that are, older than us, when you are growing up, that you know, I don't know why in the system. One of those such companies that pays me most is Eleganza Coolers. Because when I was growing up, I know Eleganza Coolers and family a bit. And I know that it's about the only product or about the only company that produces such a product. But when family problems set in, and the mother thing set in, and then time will get, social class came. And now, I'm not sure if you can find Eleganza product anywhere. Because of that, they are forced to divest. Yes, they still have money, but they divested. And some other business, I mean, there's this battery. I think it's along the solar road. There's one other battery there. Better. Some of those programs, some of those ideas, were there, tried it, but they were not established on good structure. That's another thing that affects a lot of business ideas around here. And we see how many businesses running on that kind of a family idea, personal idea, it's all about me. Even when we have a Nobel idea, we don't give solid structure. Before you know it, it collapses. One of the things that endeared me to this program is the fact that it's a kind of program to acknowledge and reward those that are really working hard to contribute to the economy. If we have many more small businesses around, before you know it, in fact, that is the only solution that can cure unemployment. Because if everyone of us here sits there, have a business, and you're able to employ 5 people, you can imagine what problem you are solving. And that's where our GDP really can go anywhere. Multinational, the big corporations will not solve the problem. And because they will not solve the problem, if as entrepreneurs, as small business owners also, we are not working hard to come with developed ideas, we also will not solve any problem. We will just be there to make money. And after you make the money and there's no good idea, somebody else is gone. Look at what has happened to Coca-Cola and Diggy. Diggy is giving Coca-Cola serious hard time at their level. And I want to say this to you that Coca-Cola budget for advertisement every year is even more than some states in Nigeria budget. But what Coca-Cola does is that when they fight you, consume you, and buy you over. So Biggie is giving them tough times. I hope Biggie will last long. Because I don't want to see that kind of action. Now, the reason is because they are able to do a very thorough research and they came up with something that seems to give them a very tough time. Now, I was in the midst of some guys, we call ourselves designers, I don't know if they are here, tailors. The real names are women, tailors, but they call them designers. And I was talking to them, I said, how many of you have heard about some of the important names that have been in this business? Some of the Surah Taylor, some of the Joe Taylor, and what have you. Have you done research to find out what happened to them? And why are you not having them around now? Some of them are looking at me. I said, let me say this to you. You might be making weight now because you are sowing for a celebrity. When that celebrity no longer becomes a celebrity, so what happened to your business? And I also share this with people that because your brother or your family member is not a commissioner, I can easily give you fund, you are establishing a business. What happened when you have commissioners? And because these are some of the things we do, and that is why our business doesn't last long. We don't solve problems. You only want to show up. You can't start a business and think the next thing is to have a hurry of cars you want to display on the road. If those cars are not to solve problems, you don't display, it's a display of wealth, and it's a matter of time, because you won't be able to, the business are not even sustained to start it. And I always say this to people, take me on it, and I always say, you don't need to start a business. Money is not the first thing to start any business. I start to be corrected.
Money is not the first thing. What is most important is having the right idea. Money is necessary, but it's not the most important thing. Most times, and I'll say this to you, most times, as you are sitting here, somebody give me 1.1 billion naira now, you say, okay, you know what, let me keep the money in the bank first, I'm going to think about what I want to do. You know what, even the business you are doing now, you are afraid to pump that money inside. Because why? You have not done enough research on what you are doing now that makes you to feel that if I have which amount of money, what can I do? And I want to also say this to you that even the business you are doing now, if you make unprecedented profits, the likelihood is that you will waste the money because it will be too solid. You know why? There's no structure, there's no plan. Now get me right. Business plan is not the prerequisite to start a business. It's not extremely important to start a business, but it's very necessary if you can't get it down. Because sometimes we feel if I don't have money and if I don't have business plan, I can't start. Many businesses started, and now what we do is that we now have to write the business plan for them and they pay much more money. It's good, and I'm recommending that you can get your business plan. But if you don't have one, you still need to do something, a short plan for your business. And I want to say this to us. Some businesses make huge profits suddenly and they collapse, and that's the end of that business. Huge profits can kill a business. So it's not only lack of money. Sometimes too much money can kill some business. You know why? Because at that level, the owner of some business, you know what they do? They get confused. And then they feel like, okay, now that we have made money, let's spend the money. So what am I saying? Your business, your idea must be one that you continue to improve on, research on, and look at what else can you do. During the recession, I spoke about how to make more money in recession. And I said the simplest thing you need to do. You know, for me, my definition of recession is this. It's a period where there's still money, but the money has priority. The money is not available for frivolity. Some of us feel in recession there's no money. There's money. I made money in recession. And what did I do? I look at my service, I look at my products. And I try to bring more products, innovations. I created more avenue to make more money. Now, what we do, one of the things we do is we do consultancy services. So we do training, we do recruitment. Now, in recession, because people are not going to invest. Very low. People are not saying we will not do internal training, so training will be low. What did I have to do? I still have to eat. Then I evolved some other ideas. And I realized that those ideas are working, and I start making money. So, what recession is saying that companies, organizations will place priority on certain things, and they will stop doing some things. Even you, as an individual, during recession, if before you give somebody £5,000, now you say, you know what, just money is £5,000. So you have a power. It doesn't mean that there's no money. It's only that there's a definition now how the money goes. So what it means is that for you, for your business to really thrive, what we call is that you need to look at your business line. You need to look at, okay, for instance, if you are into production of pure water, part of your plan should be you want to produce that nylon that you use for packaging your pure water eventually. If you are into production of bottled water, part of your plan should be you want to have your own blowing factory that supplies what the best. So if you have such plan, when you have sudden injection of funds, you only know what to do. You just maximize what you call capacity. Because sometimes the space you have can still accommodate more business opportunities. The equipment you have can still accommodate some more, but you don't need is a fresh idea. A fresh innovation. Just be creative. And again, when we talk about creativity, when you buy some items over here, you find that by the time you are unwrapping it from the package, you're like, ah, where is the product now? I'm telling you, this microphone can be wrapped in a box as big as this. And you're like, why? And this is one of the things that I've got some people attracted, the packaging alone. And so we need to be a bit creative on how we do businesses. I mean, let me take again our designers, our tailors. I went to a wedding
And I saw a guy, you know, I saw, you know, the couples, the guy actually, and then the women, and I like the way their suits were, you know, cut and all of that. And then, and I was asking, and luckily, the guy that sold the suit was around, was sharing his business card. And I just engaged him, I told him, he said, yes, fine. And then, can you do me a sample? And he said, I mean, just a, what do you call it now? What do you call this one now? The editor, yeah. And then, can you do something like that? And then, he said, how it works. And then, so fine. So, he took it, corner, he measured me. In 2 days after, he got the clothes and said, where is your office? Let me come and drop it. And he dropped it. He said, if you like, you can make payment. And I was surprised. My tailor was saying, no, okay, you don't pay, I don't go so. This one said, if you like, you can pay. And then I love it. And I said, okay, you know what, do me one and father, do me 2, 3 senator. I said, no problem. The guy delivered, he said, if you like, pay. And that has been the order. And that made me stop paying any other tailor again. It was just a bit innovative. Before I know, one of my friends abroad just said, I saw one of your clothes online. I want the tailor to do 5, and I gave him his number. The guy, he saw it. And that's how. For me, that's creativity. Some people say, pay your money. When you like it, pay. It's not common. So you need to do something different. Something a bit, what we call sometimes, maybe you want to call it unique selling point. Something a bit different. You need to be creative. Because why? There are tailors, there are designers. What will make you stand out? And the truth is that his job is so superb. But what we are talking about is the relationship, customer relationship, customer service is also different. Because even if it's not to sew it for free, and I don't like it, I won't say wear it. I was forced to go online and say, you know what, I recommend this guy. And he told me not less than 5 people that don't even know me, patronize him. And that's one thing for us that can make our business excel. I always say this to entrepreneurs, business owners, never allow any customer, whatever it was, to leave your presence, leave your business, or leave your office disgruntled, unhappy. Even if it's not going to patronize you, make sure you manage that. You know why? To gain a customer, you need to talk to not less than 10. If you lose one, you lose about multiplication of that, about 100. Because the word of mouth, it kills business. And that's one of the things you need to get right as business owner here. Our customer service, the value we place on customers must be very, very important. Now, by sharing people that have traveled some countries, it's not as if sometimes they don't have errors or they don't make mistakes. But the way they handle it and they treat it is totally different from the way we treat it there. When we say customer is a king, now we always say as much as possible, the way you will respect the king. Try and respect your customer. The kind of special reality treatment you give to your customer, not because they are special, not because they are not sometimes wrong, or all of the time they are not wrong, but because they are the people that go out and talk about your business. And what they say, people believe. Sometimes if you go, if you want to download that app and you want to look at the rating, you will see so many comments. Those comments, what else that I think 1, 3, 4, 5 comments, it's good, it's nice, oh, it's not bad. That's when I can lose out. When I say, they are crazy, I don't say, yeah. Even when I read it, I don't say that. And that's the word of mouth. And again, part of creativity and innovation for us as business owners, you must take the technology advantage. You must, no matter what business you are doing, even if it's shit selling or packing, you need to go there. You can't say, I don't know how to do it, I don't know how to. And I say to people, you are on Instagram, you are on Facebook, you are on WhatsApp, you are on this or that, all you do is to gossip. Talk about somebody else. When will you talk about your business or your idea? Even where you work, if it's not your business, when will you talk about it? Now you get back to us and say, they are passing on, they say, we are not making money, I'm not performing. Because you don't seize the moment, the spaces you have, what have you done with it? So for us as business owner, you must talk about your business. There's no one thing I will not talk about my business or my product. You are my next one, you must get it. Whether you need it now or no, sometimes, somewhere, you may have reasons why you need to recommend it.
So for us as business owner, the technology is an advantage for us. So we need to now look at how we can seize that advantage and make sure our product, our services fit into it and be creative about it. Buy one, get 10. When they come, talk about the 10 you want to get. You need to seize the opportunity and be creative. We can't do business the way our forefathers or our parents have done it. We have, because why? You are dealing with millennials and they make decisions fast. Even you here, you make decisions fast. When I want to buy a product, I start talking, okay, you know, I went to market yesterday, I went to soup myself. The person that happened, I'm married, I don't know whether this one has happened. So I went to soup, so I went to the market. All right, so I was talking to, I want to buy a plate of egg, so I was talking to the first woman I met. And then she was like, talking to someone else, I just walked away. I just said, my mind, she's not ready for business. Even when I need that product, if I'm not welcome, there's no point wasting my time. So I went to the next man sending campaign. The moment I said, out of the, your side telling me this one. Before I said, wait, don't worry, I understand. We want to cook soup. You want to grind this. Before I said, wait, the thing that grinding is ready. This is what is important. Even if I want to still negotiate, it's already grabbing for having business. And I said to you, I saw something today. Somebody shared a story of a lady from Marco, but I don't know what I was doing. The parents and to fishing and what have you. And I think I can say many times. Then the lady was able to get that house for, develop something for the family. Then you can now buy online. Book, they buy the fish and what have you. Just like crazy. You know why? There's always fish seller. There are products, there are businesses that people are doing and they will be doing. But the only reason why you will go to that market is to make a difference, be innovative and creative about it. And you make your money. People are doing oil and gas, they will see you tomorrow. But what will stand you out? People are selling rice, what will stand you out? People are doing agricultural products, what will stand you out? That's what we talk about, is being innovative and creative. Especially because people who are selling now are even extraordinarily creative. So if I were your tailor or designer, I won't wait till when you want to sew. I will be the one to put to you some design that will be high statue. Have you seen my latest design?
Yes, my brother.
See, you will be forced to spend your money. Sometimes you just say to our client, say, we have this free coming up, send one of your staff for free. Before you say, okay, we'll send five, one for free. Have you not got what you want? You want them to attend. But it's not normal. Somebody says, send for free. Sometimes say, you know what? We won't mind to come around to your office and just share with your staff for free. What we are doing, we are letting them know that we are still very much here anytime you need us. Even when we are giving this one free, we pay for it somehow in the future. So as business owners, we must be on top of our game. And let me say this as I close. Do not rely on your staff to make your business succeed. They remain staff. However, there are different kinds of staff too. There are staff I call entrepreneurs. You are the entrepreneur, they are entrepreneurs. The difference between an ordinary staff and entrepreneur one is the fact that your idea, the entrepreneur one, also comes with another idea that can make your idea succeed. But the other kind of staff, okay, how do we do it this way, do this way, end of the month, that's all right. That's what they are talking about. But don't, okay, have you talked to the client? What did they say? Occasionally, personally, when I do this, I've programmed. I won't come to the office. I just drag around all our client offices. I just say, Mr. Yo, what are you doing? I said, I just come to say thank you for coming, you know, and I come to hear the complaint you have. But don't tell me the good thing my staff are doing. What is the complaint? That makes them feel that, okay, this guy is still serious about the business. They won't feel you're not making money, you're not doing this. And that's why, honestly, I read, Richard Branson. I follow him so
good.
He got sometimes on the plane. He got sometimes we work with the staff, the lower staff. Just want to boost the morale of the staff and also to give the customer the client more assurance. We need to do that. Your business, no matter how big it is, you need to do that. You need to be on top of the game. The only reason why you have structure and you release your business for other staff to run it is
so that you can stay back and think more, look widely, and do more research. But from time to time, you need to also be part of the business. Be involved. Don't be too big. And when you do that, you will understand some of the things, some of the feedback that will make the business stronger. And you'll also be able to pick some of the things you need to do differently that can serve like creativity and innovation. So I want to encourage us, and I also want to challenge us, that the 21st business, the 21st century businesses are highly flexible. Things can change overnight. There's one of the services we do, we call it background check. We do it. But realize that people don't take advantage of it. So I just said to myself, you know, we will package it as a special service. Then we'll write to our clients that we have this service. And before you know it, one, two, three, okay, can you see some time before? These have always been there. But the truth is that because they play one of the things we provided, so as we single it out, that's when they understand that, oh, this is actually the law of sense. So sometimes, look at your business, look at the service, the environment you serve, look at your clients, look at what else can you do to solve their problem, because they already have something. Everyone come for another time bar solution. And when you do all this, and when you take advantage of your business environment, I can assure you that you begin to have a lot of those businesses that are highly innovative and solving the problem and probably the highest of Nigeria. I want to, on this note, thank you for listening to me. I wish you all the best.